At this point, we know what is a mathematical model we need to solve. It's a boundary value problem, partial differential equations with boundary conditions plus an algebraic equation. Let's think about how the tool that we have, Fluent, will solve it numerically for us, and it'll do this using the finite volume method. If I go back to the framework of what's inside the black box, we are moving from talking about the mathematical model, which we know what it is, to talking about what is a numerical solution procedure. And in your mind, make sure you're distinguishing between the two, because a big misconception I see, even with experienced users, is lumping the numerical solution alongside, you know, altogether with the mathematical model. No, they are two, you know, separate animals. And the numerical solution procedure that Fluent uses, as do many industry CFD codes, is the finite volume method. And in the finite volume method, you divide the domain into multiple control volumes or cells. So in our case, the domain is a rectangle, and you would divide that into cells. And there, you know, you have your choice of how you divide it. Here, just for illustration, I divided it into 12 rectangles. And each of these little chunks would be called a cell in the finite volume method, but you can also think of them as control volumes, if you're familiar with that idea. And then you reduce the problem to determining the, you know, our primary variables, the seven functions that we have at selected points, which are the cell centers in the flavor of the finite volume method that Fluent uses. So we determine, you know, our seven variables at these 12 cell centers, if you have 12 cells. And these are the selected points, so you're not determining it everywhere. And that idea is called discretization, okay? So you've discretized a problem. And then what about if I want to find my variable, say, the axial velocity at an intermediate point? What you'd do is you would use interpolation, which seems quite obvious. So use interpolation to determine variables away from cell centers. So if I want to know, you know, halfway between, let's say halfway between these two cell centers, what's the value, I would just use an average between these two values. If I want to know, you know, the value over here, you would use an interpolation between these four values. You would call those, I mean, you can think of that, you know, as a weighted average. Okay, so two key ideas here: discretization and interpolation. And both of the, I mean, most numerical methods, you know, have these built into it: discretization and interpolation. So the crux of the problem is, how do we determine these cell center values of our seven variables? Okay, velocity, pressure, etc. At the cell centers. So what you do is, or what Fluent will do is, it'll take our boundary value problem and it'll derive a system of algebraic equations in the cell center values. And it'll do this using a control volume balance for each cell. So the idea is that each algebraic equation will relate a cell center value to its neighbors. So let's say if I had the pressure over here, it would, yeah, and write the equation for pressure, it would only involve the neighboring values. For instance, it would not involve this value or this value. This is important because, you know, usually in CFD, you have tens of thousands or maybe now even millions of cell centers. And so you have the relationships only between the neighbors, and that makes the problem tractable. So you have a system of algebraic equations that relate the neighboring values, and then you invert it and you get the cell center values of our seven variables. And then once you do that, you can calculate whatever you want, say pressure, axial velocity, everywhere in the domain, wall shear, etc., by interpolation. And in fact, for wall shear, you'll have to interpolate and differentiate, okay? And that process is called post-processing. And an additional wrinkle is that the algebraic equations that you get, the system of algebraic equations, is nonlinear because our partial differential equations are nonlinear, so you have to bring in linearization too. So there's discretization and also linearization. And here's an overview of the process. So this is a boundary value problem, differential form of the governing equations plus boundary conditions. And ultimately, you want to go to algebraic equations. And in the finite volume method, you do that by going to the integral form of the governing equations. So for instance, mass conservation, you can write it for a vanishingly small chunk of fluid. That'll give you the differential form of mass conservation, which is what we saw. But you could also write mass conservation for, you know, an arbitrary control volume within your flow domain, and and say that, hey, you know, the mass coming in should be equal to the mass going out. And that's that you would use the integral form. And many of you might already come across these two forms. And this is the form you use in control volume analysis. And in the process of going from the integral form to the algebraic equations, we introduce a discretization error. So there's no error introduced in going from the differential form to the integral form. But in going from the integral form to the algebraic form, you introduce the discretization error. And to reduce that, you need to use a lot more cells. You need to use mesh refinement, which I think is an intuitive idea for most of us. But then, because the algebraic equations are nonlinear, what you have to do is you have to linearize the algebraic equations about a guess value, about guess values. So you start out with guess values, you linearize it, and then you get the linearized equations, you solve the linearized equations, and in doing that, you introduce a linearization error, okay? And so these linearized equations have to be solved iteratively, updating the guess. So you keep updating the guess until you get to a satisfactory solution. And the satisfactory solution is when the imbalances are below tolerance, imbalances of mass, momentum, energy, right? So you can go to each cell and figure out what the mass imbalances, momentum imbalances, energy imbalances, and when they fall below tolerance, you say, hey, you know, that's a good enough solution to my algebraic equations. If these imbalances were zero, you'd have an exact solution to the algebraic equations. You'll never get there. So we'll monitor the linearization error by checking the mass, momentum, and energy imbalances. That's a quick overview of how you solve the, you know, the governing equations using the finite volume method. And in my online course, in the big ideas in computational fluid dynamics, I go into more detail into this methodology. So if you want to learn more, that would be a place to go to.